Welcome back to the Magic Room, and blessings. We've returned to this place to continue our study of the Rider-Waite Tarot, one card at a time, and to explore the imagery and symbolism so we can define our own meanings. Today, we'll be looking at the card numbered at 12 in the Major Arcana, the Hanged Man. Arthur Edward Waite briefly defines this card as wisdom, circumspection, discernment, trials, sacrifice, intuition, divination, and prophecy. Once again, the card has changed very little from earlier decks, although Waite and Smith have included some subtle differences. The design of the image is based on the concept of pittura infamante, a defamatory painting style that was popular in Italian cities during the Renaissance. The subjects of the paintings were generally thieves, traitors, fraudsters, and were displayed as a way of publicly shaming the accused. At the time, this was considered a severe form of social punishment. The act itself comes from a decree of Milan and Lombardy in 1393. Let him be dragged on a plank at a horse's tail to the place of execution, and there be suspended by one foot to the gallows, and to be left there until he is dead. As long as he lives, let him be given food and drink. However, the figure on the Rider-Waite card is likely there through his own volition. As Waite himself points out in his Key to the Tarot, the face expresses deep entrancement, not suffering, a point that is further supported by the halo around the figure's head. It is significant that the Tau cross from which the figure is suspended is a living tree, with Waite saying that it should be noted first that the tree of sacrifice is living wood with leaves growing from it, affirming Waite's claim that this is a card of life and not death. The position of the figure forms that of a Falfot cross, a symbol that has become chiefly associated with the Nazi Party. However, in the time when the Rider-Waite Tarot was conceived, the Falfot was almost exclusively used in religious imagery and was considered a holy symbol all over the world. According to Waite, it is a card of profound significance, but all the significance is veiled. It has been called falsely a card of martyrdom, a card of prudence, a card of the great work, a card of duty. But we may exhaust all published interpretations and find only variety. It would seem that the interpretations of this card in antiquity were shrouded in mystery and divergence. The card is often taken as a suggestion that we may need to put things on hold, with Waite saying that the figure as a whole suggests life in suspension. It can be read as a sign that perhaps we need to take stock of our situation and see things from a new perspective. Should we require a divination in the reverse position, Waite suggests the following: selfishness, the crowd, and body politic. The card is the 12th to be met by the Fool along his journey, and is thought to be the time when he first encounters the concept of surrender. The Hanged Man teaches the Fool about the wisdom to be gained from personal sacrifice. The card can be read as an indicator that it could be time to let go of an aspect of our lives, and that we may be clinging on to something that is no longer benefiting us. Waite summarizes the card as the following: I will say very simply, on my own part, that it expresses the relation, in one of its aspects, between the divine and the universe. Certainly, the themes of wisdom through sacrifice are abundantly clear in this, the card numbered at 12 in the tarot deck. Thank you so much for joining us in the Magic Room. May the coming days bring you clarity, awareness, and evolution. Until next time.